Welcome, guys. We've been doing hide and seek. I know I've been away for so long. Nigerians will say, I don't jackpa. I left. So I'm in the UK with a big man himself.
Hello, everybody. Wow. He's going to make me famous now.
Hey, I'm going on Rainbow interview. Anyway, so boss, let me follow your lead. You know, I was about to enter through here.
It's always like that. You know,
wearing a seat belt has never been my thing.
Are you serious?
Yeah, when I go here.
Oh my goodness.
When I go here, I was like, no one needs to remind me, I have to wear it.
No, for us, like, it's second nature.
Yeah.
Like, it's like, you know, when something just comes to you, or it's part of you, you don't even think twice before doing it.
Mm-hmm.
So immediately you sit in the car, you just see your hand going like this. Because one of the things that any law enforcement person going around, police, yeah, they can't, no matter where they spot you, you'll be stopped and fined.
You know, we once picked Uber.
Mm-hmm.
I sat in it, front seat, and I just forgot when the driver was like, seat belt. I'm like, man, relax, where I'm from, we don't give a damn. But I think I've adjusted, like, I wear it.
Oh, you will.
Time, yeah.
And the thing is, there are a lot of the offenses. It's the person who is driving who will be charged. But for seatbelts, is where they will find, they will find you, especially if you are an adult.
Mm-hmm.
They will only find the person driving if the is a child who is, let's say, I think it's 13 or 14 thereabout, who is like underage that they can't charge. Yeah. So you are responsible for making sure. But an adult who should be responsible, yeah, the law rather, they will find the person rather.
So what of the back seat?
So the back seat, it has to be, the seat has to be, but it is not as stringent as the front seat.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not that, because you know, if there is an impact, the front seat is where life can easily be lost. So they are very, very, very particular about that. And when you are doing your driving test here, I think it's the first thing.
Seat belt.
Absolutely, seat belt. Seat belt. And then with driving over here, they have something they call hazard perception. So you are trained not to just be driving, but as you are driving, you are checking potentially someone who can cause the accident. Okay. So I think in Ghana they rather call it defensive driving or something, but yeah, it's hazard perception. And you do a whole course and test on it. If you don't, you can pass all the other segments. If you don't pass that, you can't get a license.
Wow.
You'll not get a license unless you pass your hazard perception test. And it's practical, so they've simulated, if you are doing the test, the road has been simulated in a video, and you will be asked to spot potential hazards and click on it in a timely manner.
But I think most Ghanaians will pass this test.
You think so?
Or they fail a lot?
Most Ghanaians, I don't know, but
in Ghana?
the times that I've driven in Ghana, people don't pay attention to what is around them.
But
they only focus on just driving.
I don't think they don't pay attention. They do pay attention, but they don't care.
Okay.
That's what I'm saying. Every Ghanaian might pass the, like, they just don't care. Okay, Fabra, they buy them Fabri, like that kind of lifestyle.
Yeah. But here you are thinking, Charlie, because if the Fabri happens, one, your time.
True.
And you know, two, if you go through insurance, your premium will go up. Like, you don't need those stress. So you are very careful.
Mm-hmm.
You know, everybody is careful. And the law works as well. I'm sure you've seen that.
It's for instance,
if there's somebody on this deal zebra crossing, there is no way I can go past.
Yes.
If I go past and I'm reported with evidence, or there is a police car behind me, instantly I will be fined.
You know, I've tried it, I've tested it a couple of times. I get to a zebra crossing, I just stand there, Everybody stops. Like, will stop. As if there's an accident about to happen.
Everybody will stop.
They just stop, boom, boom, boom. I just pass.
Everybody will stop.
I was tempted to thank them. I was like, oh my God, leave the Ghana out of this.
Yeah.
I mean, okay, that's the African in us. We are so generous.
Absolutely.
And so kind.
Absolutely. But some people do that though. Some people, when you stop at a zebra, they will say, oh, thank you. Because as much as majority of people obey the law and follow the rules, because the system is very stringent, and there are some too who
So it's not weird, it's not like JJC kind of thing. If you
No, it's not at all. Oh, there are people who they will just pass and they will thank you,
okay,
and stuff, because there are some they may not be paying attention, maybe they are on their phone or they are doing something, so they will just pass. So if you don't take, but with that, if anything happens at a zebra crossing, Charlie, you are in so much trouble.
Oh,
because that one, the responsibility is on the driver 100%.
Yes, and this place, I've noticed one thing as well. They really care about kids.
Oh,
if you have your kid with you, priority, everything, priority is on you.
Children and women. Children first, women, then the elderly, the like the vulnerable, and then disabled. So in that manner, men.
Yes, go away. We were once standing by a coffee shop, and we're really not entering.
Okay.
We're just like waiting. I think one of our guys was buying something inside, so we're waiting. Everyone was trying to open the door for us. They try to open the door because of their baby.
Wow!
Everyone, I'm like, wow. These people really care about kids.
Wow. And have you tried the bus?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yes. Priority.
But if you see designated places, pregnant women, children. Baby,
yes. Yeah. And even on
and
the train
as well. Yeah. Yes. The system is
working. The system works.
I mean, look, have you seen? So there is this, you see the traffic enforcement camera. If I breach any condition, you don't have to do anything. It's a charge. 3 days, 4 days. They will send you a fine. Maybe £180. If you pay within 14 days, they will reduce it by 50%. If you try to say, oh, it's not you, no problem.
You go to court.
They will send you evidence.
Wow.
Oh, they will send you evidence with your car number, a video of the car moving, everything. There is nowhere to hide. You can't dispute it.
Anyway, guys, this is the system we are in now, and we'll surely adjust and we'll make you guys home proud.
You'll be fine.
When I came fresh, it was a bit like stressful. You know, you wanted us to meet, and
I understand.
Like when I think of everything, Charlie, I'm not ready. Meet me. It was scary. Like I don't know if I'm the only one, but it was stressful.
It can be overwhelming sometimes. And in your case, you've come with the family. So that is what makes it very stressful.
Yes.
You've come with Mrs. and the baby. If it was even just the two of you alone, you know, you could do things. But Charlie, with baby. It's too much work.
Baby crying, baby trying to enter everywhere.
It's a lot of work.
It's stress. It's getting better.
It will be very, very fine. I mean, the good thing is that you know, you see the transport system is on point. If the bus, you check the bus, and the bus is going to arrive at 8:09. If the train is moving at 8:02, it's not that the train is arriving, but 8:02, the thing is moving. You know, so you are able to plan. Even if maybe you don't drive or anything like that, you're able to plan your movement and get to places on time, in a timely manner, and all those things. So, I mean, it's a good system. We really hope and pray that our country will get to that point.
Amen. That's all I can say to that. Amen. Okay, guys, so yes, we are going to have the interview. Hopefully, I'll do my version of the recording, and I'm going to see it. Remember to subscribe to this channel. We are back. Okay, we are back. Peace out.